Hello, I'm Dr Nitin, and today we are going to see how to present using PowerPoint to our advantage. Now you may say, what is there? I just start the presentation, click, 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 next slide, and press escape to finish. No, that's just the bare minimum. But there are so many nice things available in PowerPoint which help you present better. Now, instead of saying all this, why not see it in action? So let's go to the studio and have a live demo. Let's go. Now we are back in studio. Let's see this in action. I have a very simple PPT, and you can also download it from the link in the description. I'm going to run this the traditional way. So we go to the slideshow menu from beginning. Remember the shortcut F5. If you want to run it from any slide, then it is Shift F5 or from current slide. But that's okay. Most of us will just run the PPT from beginning, click, 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 and then at the end we will press escape to finish. What's the big deal? The big deal is, apart from this, there are so many beautiful and powerful things you can do. Example, I'm somewhere in between the show and someone says, no, show me that earlier slide. What do? You press escape and then struggle to find the slide. Don't do that. Remember this miraculous shortcut, minus key, just the minus key. Now it shows you something like a slide sorter view, and then you can jump to any slide anytime. So I went to this smart art slide. Now I have pressed minus again. I'm going to some other slide, say conditional formatting. I'm going to press minus again and going to another slide. Let's say the title slide. Now someone wants another previous slide. Where do I go? Right click and look at this beautiful option that's called last viewed slide. That's not the same as previous slide. Previously viewed slide. So I go to last viewed, again last viewed, again last viewed. You see, it remembers the entire progression. Very, very useful. And now it has become inactive because there is nothing to see before this step. Another beautiful thing which is nice and useful is, let's say you have been given 20 minutes time slot in a seminar. You are the fourth presenter. Now suddenly, when you are about to go on stage, someone is saying, sorry, you have to do it in half the time. You are not prepared. What do you do? Generally, what happens is, I will run the PPT, initial few slides I will try to consciously do fast. But now I realize that there is no more time left. People are showing you signs, 1 minute, 0 minute, bouncers are standing next to you. And now you have to finish and you are hanging somewhere in between. How do you elegantly come out of this? When you are about to start the PPT, you know you have to finish it in half the time. It's a stressful situation. So if you have to suddenly quit, thank you is not the best slide. Summary would be a good slide. So even if you couldn't cover everything, something you can touch upon in 1 minute. How do you do that? You remember the number of the summary slide. Write it down somewhere, 1-5. And now let's reproduce the situation. I am somewhere in between and now I am forced to quit. What do? I type the number 1-5. Nothing will be seen on the screen and then press enter. And now elegantly I can wrap up, maybe cover things which I missed completely and have a much more professional end to my presentation. Superb, useful. It is there for 28 years. Okay, now let's move to something completely different. Do you have hidden slides? Of course. Why do we hide slides? Because in the normal flow of things, you don't think those are relevant. But maybe sometimes you need them. So I have a slide about themes. Themes means colors, fonts, all that. Most companies create a PowerPoint template based on their brand guidelines. But their Word and Excel is always default. Where is the branding on now? So I have a slide for branding, how to do it properly. But because most people may not be interested, I have hidden that slide. Now here is the situation. I am actually running this presentation for a customer. I am on the theme slide. I know there is a slide next to this slide which is hidden. And now the customer asks me, show me how this happens across Word, Excel, PowerPoint. Now I should be happy because I am prepared. But actually I am unhappy because unless I press escape, there is no way of showing that hidden slide. Because it's hidden, PowerPoint will not show it. So here is the hidden way of showing a hidden slide. I know it is there, so press H. And now if the next slide is hidden, it will be shown. In fact, it's written there for 20 years plus. If you had pressed F1 during a presentation, H is go to hidden slide if it is the next one. Now let's look at a revolutionary way of reorganizing your PPTs. PPTs grow over time and they get inflated. Here I have Word, Excel, PowerPoint and summary, four broad topics, but they are just one next to each other. I want some structure there. I want something like a menu. What do you do? You go to the insert menu and choose zoom, summary, zoom. And then select the slides wherever a new topic starts. So Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and the last one, which is the summary, call to action, whatever you want to call it. Now it's saying 4 slides are selected. Okay, insert. Now miraculous things happened. It created a separate section for each of the topics. It also created a separate section for this menu slide. So now what happens when I click, I get a nice menu driven structure, interactive. So I can ask people, what do you want? I go there. Notice it directly goes to Excel. Excel has few slides. It's not going to spill over to PowerPoint. It's going to come back. I have not put a single hyperlink. Can you believe the sophistication you got in just few clicks? And as though this is not enough, sometimes it happens that I am halfway through. If I finish this part, I'll go to the main menu, but I want to go right now. What do you do? Shift. Notice right side, shift key and left arrow. It'll take me to the main menu wherever I was. I'm sure now you realize how powerful this is, so that you can put forward your point with power using PowerPoint. If you found it useful, please like the video and share it with your colleagues and loved ones. It's equally important that you subscribe and click the bell icon so that we are more encouraged to create great content like this. Thank you.